Welcome to MooMooMath. Today we are going to look at the volume of prisms and cylinders. So here's our volume formula. It's equal to the base area times the height. So what you need to do is you need to look at your prism and decide what the base is. Well, I'm going to shade my base so I can see it. Okay, so there's a base, and the base has to be, the other base has to be parallel to it. So there are my two bases. So they're rectangles. So the area of a rectangle is equal to length times width. So I'm going to take my length and my width and multiply those together. So my base area is 24 centimeters squared. Now to find the volume, I'm going to take that base area times the height. Well, the height of the pyramid is 5 in this case. So let's just take 24 times 5, and let's grab our calculators. And we get 120. Now, for volume, our units are always cubic. So there is the volume in cubes. Now, let's look at one that's a little bit harder because the base is a different shape. Okay, the base of this one is our triangle. Sometimes you would think it would be this rectangle on the bottom, but it doesn't have a side that's parallel to it. So always look for your bases that are parallel to each other. So now I'm going to take this triangle and draw it over here. It's a right triangle with a base of 4 and a height of 6. So what is the area of a triangle to find the base area? The triangle's formula is 1/2 base times height. So let's take our base and our height and multiply it by 1/2. 1/2 of 4 times 6. 4 times 6 is 24. Half of that is 12. So 12 is my base area. And then I'm going to take that times the height of the pyramid. Well, because this pyramid is on its side, you've got to, sometimes you want to turn your paper so you can see it, but this is the height of the pyramid. So we're going to take the base area, again, take your base area times the height of the pyramid, 8 times 12, and that is 96 cubic centimeters. So that's how you would find the volume of a triangular prism. So whatever your base is, plug in your area formula for your base, then times the height of the pyramid.